Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. In the name of Allah, the Gracious, the Merciful. Connect to Allah because this line is never busy, always answered, no hang up, no heartbreak. Allah has made it easy. So read Quran with translation. Connect to your Allah. Please watch previous video on enlarged lymph nodes. You know the normal microanatomy and causes of enlargement of lymph nodes. Today we will going to discuss chronic lymphadenitis. The commonest is TB lymphadenitis. Tuberculosis lymphadenitis, any age group, belongs to patients usually belongs to poor socio-economic background. There is history of weight loss, night sweats. Usually there is associated pulmonary TB and patients are malnourished. So if there is pulmonary tuberculosis, you know there is cough, emaciated patient, history of night sweats, there is low grade fever, sometimes there is hemoptysis or blood streaking, and because of chronic infection there is also raised ESR. Now, stages of tuberculosis lymphadenitis. First of all, there is lymphadenitis, then due to the invasion of mycobacteria, then periadenitis, then there is central caseation leading to cold abscess, then collar stud abscess, and then there is sinus, because the caseous material it burst and there is formation of sinus. So upper deep cervical chain and posterior triangle lymph nodes are involved. There is development of periadenitis, that's why the lymph nodes are mated, they are adherent to each other, and because of development of caseation necrosis, it is called cold abscess. And abscess tracking down to skin forms subcutaneous collection causing collar stud abscess, and then abscess bursts spontaneously, and then there is tuberculosis sinus and drainage of the caseous material to on the skin. So this is the summary of the tuberculosis lymphadenitis. Stage 1 adenitis, stage 2 periadenitis, stage 3 caseation necrosis in the center, and stage 4 collar stud abscess, and stage 5 sinus tract formation. So patient can present with any of these stages, and here you can see enlarged lymph nodes with draining sinuses. Now the presentation is 20 years old female presented with cervical lymphadenopathy. She gave history of weight loss and night sweats, and ESR is 60 millimeter in first hour. So there is, as you can appreciate, there is swelling in the posterior cervical area. There is raised ESR. So whenever there is chronic lymphadenitis or lymph node enlargement more than 6 weeks, the cervical lymph node must go for biopsy for the confirmation of the lesion, because you know TB is a chronic infection and it takes longer duration to take treatment, almost 7 to 9 months. So patient's cervical lymph node was biopsied and sent for histopathological examination. Here is the excised lymph node. You can appreciate it is enlarged in size, and there are cut surface shows chalky white areas. These chalky white areas represents caseous necrosis, because in the caseous necrosed tissue there is deposition of calcium salts. So the gross description is: size of the lymph node is enlarged, 3 cm long, firm inconsistency if you want to touch, fresh specimen, cut surface show chalky white areas, and other samples showing chalky white areas in the lymph nodes. Now after processing the lymph nodes sections, they are observed under microscope. Now we see what are the special features which mycobacterium tuberculosis infection give rise. So there is caseous necrosis, granulomas with central caseation. Granuloma is the collection of epitheloid cells with Langhans type giant cells, multinucleated giant cells, and epitheloid cells are activated macrophages, and they are surrounded by collar of lymphocytes. So we can appreciate there is amorphous pink center which is called caseous necrosis. Then there are elongated nuclei of epitheloid cells, and there are small dot-like lymphocytes in the section. So if we summarize the histopathological findings, we can say loss of nodal architecture, caseating granulomas, epitheloid cells, Langhans giant cells, caseation necrosis, and collar of lymphocytes. So keeping in view the clinical presentation, the gross findings and the histopathologic findings, so weight loss, young female, night sweat, cervical lymphadenopathy, raised ESR, and caseating granulomas, there is provisional diagnosis of tuberculosis lymphadenitis. So whenever we make a diagnosis, we keep in mind the clinical presentation, the gross features, and histopathological examination. Next will be on lymphadenopathy due to lymphoma. I think you have enjoyed the lesson. Please subscribe the channel, like and share the video.